Welcome to the Inyo Craters. So we came up a little half-mile access path to get here. The Inyo Craters are a series of volcanic features related to the intrusion of a big rhyolite dike in AD 1350. So in some places, that dike just pushed open a fissure in the ground like we saw at the last stop. In some places, it made large, moderate-sized effusive volcanoes. So the hill in the background, I think, is Deer Mountain, which is actually a rhyolite flow, where that rhyolite magma made it to the surface and piled up in a rhyolite dome. Again, rhyolite magma is extremely stiff, so it doesn't really flow out readily. It just sort of piles up in a sort of toothpaste-like mound. Now, there are a couple other features, and so there are a whole bunch of these rhyolite domes, and we'll see obsidian dome is another one of these formed in AD 1350 that we'll see a little bit later. But there are also these big explosive craters like this one here. Now, the way a crater like this forms is by something called a phreatomagmatic eruption. Basically, if you have magma intruding in a place where there's a lot of groundwater, that groundwater can boil the steam. And if that steam doesn't have any place to go, the pressure in the steam can build up until it's enough to create a significant explosion. So typically an eruption like this will happen by some sort of an intrusion of the magma underground interacting with groundwater. Today the groundwater table is probably about the depth of that lake. So presumably it may have been a similar depth in the past. At some point some of the groundwater down there became superheated, basically. And water expands by a factor of about 1,000 when it boils with steam, and that expansion can create pretty large explosions under the right conditions. Actually, I'll just keep filming as we walk up. There's actually two of these big explosion pits here. It's also called a phreatomagmatic crater, or a MAR, M-A-A-R. Oh, I'm on the wrong side of the fence. So here we want to take a trip to Mars with two A's. You know where to go. So this little rim we're walking on is basically the ejecta rim of the material blasted out of the hole. Now, some of that material may have actually been some of the magma, rhyolite magma, but probably a lot of the material blasted out of this hole was simply pre-existing country rock. It was overlying the area where the steam was generated. So here is a second phreatomagmatic crater. This one has been filled in with trees. Not quite as deep as the other one, but still pretty significant. Okay. From here you can get a slightly better sense of the scale of the crater now that you can see across. Actually, it looks like there is a little bit of a lake down in there at the bottom. Maybe if we go around this way, you can see it a little better. So you can see in the edge here, at the very top part is this sort of gray part with loose stones. All that is the ejecta, thrown out probably by early parts of the eruption. Or probably thrown out doing it, and now the crater is probably expanded outwards due to erosion. It's probably actually what it is. There we go. Yeah, there's actually a significant lake down there. A little more natural looking than the other one. The other one might have some hydrothermal activity going on or something like that that makes it toxic and unpleasant for things to grow in. Okay, well, our next stop, we're going to continue north along the Inyo Craters chain, and we're going to see Obsidian Dome next, which is one of the other craters in that chain.